Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and we're back with some exciting updates today. We'll start with SpaceX stacking Starship atop a massive booster for the first time to make the world's tallest rocket. Then we'll discuss the latest multi-year launch agreement between Planet and SpaceX, and at the end, an exciting job opening in SpaceX Texas facility for Spaceport Mixologist. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about U.S. defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Now let's start our discussion with SpaceX stacking Ship 20 and Booster 4 together to its full height. SpaceX is now on the road of milestones after milestones. They're getting more dominating in the space arena. On the 6th of August, after a long wait, SpaceX teams for the first time have ultimately stacked their newest Starship prototype, SN20, atop the newly built massive booster, B4. With this, SpaceX has a new world record of building the world's tallest rocket, breaking the earlier record held by NASA's Saturn V moon rocket. NASA's Saturn V had a height of 110 meters. On the other hand, Super Heavy alone rises to a height of 70 meters, and along with Starship fixed atop it rises to 120 meters, beating Saturn V by 10 meters. Elon Musk tweeted on the 6th of August, 2021, "Starship fully stacked." He further tweeted, "An honor to work with such a great team." SpaceX has recently tweeted on Twitter that Starship on the orbital launch pad, along with photos of stacked Starship, as Mechazilla is yet to be completed, SpaceX had to use the same larger crane used for constructing the launch tower to stack the ship and booster. This time, SpaceX engineers have attached the Starship SN20 atop Super Heavy Booster 4 for carrying out several tests, including the fitting checks and also thorough testing of clamps installed in booster and ship, which is used to hold the ship and booster together. In a reply tweet to Michael Sheets, Musk shared his feelings. He wrote, "Dream come true. It was expected that the two giant vehicles would be separated, as the SN20 is still a little unfinished, and so is the booster. Expectations were true. The combo of giants were mated together for nearly an hour. Later, SpaceX teams started unmating them." According to a Twitter page named SpaceX Updates Boca Chica, it said, "As expected, Ship 20 and Booster 4 are now being unmated. Both vehicles are expected to undergo testing prior to their maiden flight in the coming weeks." Still, the vehicle stood on the orbital launch table beside the launch tower, gave a majestic sight to all the Starship fans. According to a report, SpaceX had tried to complete this brief stack on the 5th of August. After a couple hours, SN20 had rolled out, but stormy winds had interrupted that attempt. Musk had stated, "Winds are too high today. Looks like wind speed will be low enough to stack early tomorrow morning." But there is some assurance from Musk to Starship fans as he says, "Once Mechazilla is operational, winds will rarely be an issue." As stated earlier, both Booster 4 and SN20 have to pass through several pressurization and engine tests before moving for final orbital liftoff. Other than the tests, both ship and booster have some other work yet to be finished. According to a report, SpaceX teams have to install remaining TPS, thermal protection system, heat shield tiles on the SN20, and also have to provide an equal protection system for Booster 4 engines. SpaceX will also have to complete the Mechazilla along with an increase in GSE propellant tanks. SpaceX is also waiting on an environmental review of Starship's launch operations being performed by the Federal Aviation Administration, and it's unclear when that review will be completed. According to a report, the agency will invite, at some point, a month-long public consultation. From NASA, Dr. Thomas Zurbuchen, a high-ranking official, said, "Yes, I've been following this all along and I am excited for SpaceX achieving this milestone. Can't wait to see it fly." Musk, in a reply tweet, wrote, "Due to its size and ability to return science instruments, even from deep space, Starship will enable a whole new class of science missions." Next, we'll discuss Planet's recent launch contract with SpaceX, covering several years till the end of 2025. On the 5th of August, 2021, Planet, a San Francisco-based Earth observation company, publicized that they've recently dealt a launch contract with SpaceX. According to the contract, SpaceX will be the go-to launch provider of Planet till the end of the year, 2025. Will Marshall, CEO of Planet, stated, "I'm excited to continue our partnership with SpaceX. We've had 7 launches to date, but more than that, we've pioneered together rapid planning, manufacturing, and launch of satellites that only Planet and SpaceX could together have achieved." According to a report, Planet will send 44 CubeSats, known as Super Doves, for the first launch under this contract. The CubeSats, or Super Doves, has power to capture images with a resolution of nearly 300 centimeters per pixel in extraspectral bands. This launch will be carried out in December this year. These 44 CubeSats will be part of SpaceX's Transporter 3 rideshare mission. As per recent updates, the total number of CubeSats will be launched under this contract is yet to be disclosed. Planet has had a relationship with SpaceX for quite a good time. SpaceX rideshare missions have become one of the most prominent launch programs besides NASA's Commercial Crew Program. The first Transporter 1 mission has carried over 143 satellites, while the Transporter 2 deployed 88 satellites. Till now, SpaceX has launched nearly 83 CubeSats of Planet. In 2020, SpaceX had launched 6 SkySats for Planet. Most recent of them was the 48 CubeSats launched on the SpaceX Transporter 1 mission in January 2021. Planet appreciated SpaceX rideshare program. They said, "SpaceX's rideshare program has allowed companies like Planet to meet their ambitious targets for product launch." Planet stated that demand for flexible, high-resolution imagery of the Earth is continuously increasing, pursuing daily global insights for their industries. They said that they'll be continuing to innovate by rapidly building satellites with the newest advances in imagery technology. Planet had launched their satellites earlier, also with ISRO's PSLV and Electron Rocket of Rocket Lab. So, from their present statement, "We will continue to operate with a variety of launch providers. It seems, along with SpaceX, they'll also go with other providers." Let's wrap up taking a look at a job opening published on SpaceX's job page. As per the latest job description, SpaceX is looking for a spaceport mixologist. This job role requires expertise to stir up drinks based on space theme somewhere near to SpaceX's rocket factory in South Texas. Space may not be a main part of a bartender's long-term vision, but who in this profession would not like to grab the coolest job title like Spaceport Mixologist and serve hundreds of employees working on SpaceX's huge Starship factory in Boca Chica, Texas? The drink station would probably be placed somewhere in a small house near to SpaceX's growing spaceport called Starbase. As per the job description, "SpaceX has a number of food service outlets and formats serving our workforce and are looking to add many more. We're searching for candidates who have superior mixology experience with a focus in resorts, bars, and full-service restaurants." At SpaceX's Boca Chica site, there's a restaurant and bar in one of their rocket-building towers that serves the whole spaceport. As per SpaceX CEO, the bar is called High Bar in the High Bay of the tower and designed as a futuristic bar with 360-degree windows and a glass floor looking down on the rocket factory. In the month of June, SpaceX hosted a party at the High Bar. As per food service categories of SpaceX's jobs page, the company is looking for dozens of people for food service jobs in Texas and California to cater their growing manpower. There are several open positions in the roles like cooks, baristas, and chefs. Though these facilities mainly serve SpaceX employees, in the future they may be open for the general public as well. As per Musk's tweet back in January, "I super support public spaces around our production and launch sites, wherever it can be done safely and securely. When COVID passes, we will open up our restaurant to the public and figure out ways to allow limited access to the High Bar." Many big tech and aerospace organizations like Google, Boeing, and Facebook are known well to employ professionals in job roles like chefs and baristas to cater to their employees. But Spaceport Mixologist? Now that's one of a kind. Neuralink, another Musk-owned company, just came up with their own bar, but not sure when the brain interface startup will employ someone in an equivalent role. Hope one day space fans like us get a chance to visit these sites and enjoy a drink by the Mixologist. That's all for today. And oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.